welcome to Living Black. I'm Carla Grant. In today's program, lateral violence counting the cost of community infighting.
We could have lost a life out of it all, and it was out of something really ridiculous.
Missing Matilba, a North Queensland town rubbed off official maps, fights to get its identity back.
There was never ever any consultation that I'm aware of, not with anyone, Aboriginal or to local people.
And cultural tourism, how it's offering a Snowy Mountain community an economic lifeline.
Between ourselves, we've made this happen. So self-determination is in play in Cooma, in our Aboriginal community, because we do for ourselves, because nobody's coming in to do for us.
Lateral violence or community infighting has been likened to cultural suicide. According to the Australian Human Rights Commission, this phenomenon is tearing our communities apart. In early 2011, the New South Wales Koori village of Wallaga Lake saw what can happen when family tensions escalate from harsh words to physical violence. Josh Ridgway was there at the time and has since returned to see if a community once in crisis can now offer a national solution.
It's March 2011 and police have been called to the Wallaga Lake Koori village where a decades-long family feud has escalated into physical violence. They find a car set on fire and some residents have blockaded entry to the community, threatening people with physical harm.
A lot of verbal abuse and then houses getting smashed. Yeah, kids were getting chased when they were waiting for buses. We could have lost a life out of it all, and it was out of something really ridiculous.
The New South Wales government used emergency powers to lock down the community, sending in a public order and riot squad. Children were relocated with other family for their safety.
Just like to see it stop, because in the last 3 months our elders couldn't get any rest, they couldn't get a sleep because of what's going on.
What happened at Wallaga Lake was an extreme example of what's known as lateral violence.
Lateral violence is the behaviour of bullying, gossiping, backstabbing, harassment, stuff we see all over society. Simple things like invitations to weddings, people being excluded from that.
At its core, Mr. Gooder says, it's internalised colonialism. Put simply, it's when an oppressed community takes out its anger and frustration on its own people. And sadly, when it comes to our mob, it's a particular concern.
We question people's Aboriginality all the time. They're not real blackfellas, they're coconuts. How can they do that? And when in fact, they are Aboriginal people. We're taking on the behaviours of what governments did years ago. You know, you're not a real Aboriginal person, so we'll separate you from your family and we'll raise you over here.
And it can have a devastating effect on young people. Mr. Gooder has even heard lateral violence being linked to suicide and self-harm in one community.
When they reach adolescence, they're expected to take part in the feuds, and for some of the kids, the only way they could see a way out of that was to end it all, and unfortunately, tragically, some did. They're the sort of wake-up calls that make communities change the way they're behaving.
A lot of our elders don't realise the cultural loads they carry.
Richard Franklin is an advocate for grassroots change. He's been running workshops like this one in Seymour, Victoria, to raise awareness of lateral violence and promote a counter-philosophy of lateral love and healing.
Stop yourself from doing it. Think good thoughts about other people. Find good things that other people have done. Don't leave your kids with the legacy of bad community feelings towards each other. They don't deserve that. Your kids, our kids, deserve a healthy, good life.
Since the Wallaga Lake lockdown, police have removed some of the residents involved in the fighting, a move some locals say has made headway for change.
It ended up a lot quieter and more peaceful.
The elders of the community, the older people on the community, they're now speaking their mind a lot more and being able to sort of say to the younger ones that just don't do this.
We are the community, we should be the ones stepping up. And as the young generation, we have to do it, because it's us. We can't rely on the elders to do everything all the time.
For now, Wallaga Lake is one community that's found some peace and the resolve to keep it.
And if you'd like to comment on that story, just go to our Facebook page.